What's not impressive is our luck with storms recently. A little shaky, quite honestly, you
hey,
guys.
It is drastically colder outside tonight.
It is
tonight.
Cold. Yeah, it's nice. We've gotten the cold and wind without having to deal with all that pesky precipitation, at least in most cases, which is not what we want. Yeah. Obviously, right. I'm trying to sell this thing. I don't know if it's going to work out. But we've gone up around the Raton Pass to get some shot here. We've had some rain and snow, and this is probably the one tricky area of the state as far as roads go. It's tough to tell here because visibility up here along the pass is a little rough. We have not seen much rain or snow up here over the past couple of hours, and I'll show you that with the radar in a moment. But the bigger story is the freeze warnings in place in Albuquerque down through Socorro and across southwestern New Mexico. Temperatures tomorrow going to be right around freezing here. So if you have vegetation, especially down in valley sections of the city here, we're going to see those temperatures drop quite a bit. And if you've got anything you can cover up, that would be a good idea. The storm tonight will continue to churn to our northwest over the Four Corners, but it has brought in a lot of cool air across the area here, and that air has drained itself in place. And throughout the night, even though we're not going to see the skies necessarily clear out in the way that we have that radiational cooling, but because we've got enough cold air draining in across the city here, it's going to be a chilly night, no doubt. 32 on the west side as you get up tomorrow morning, 31 in the Heights, 30 at the Sunport, 28 down in the valley, and 31 in the foothills. Across the northern mountains, these are some real cold temperatures. 19 Angel Fire, 17 in Eagle Nest, up in Alamosa, they'll be in the 20s, 19 in Chama, Dulce at 23, and Durango at 28. So definitely our coldest night in quite a while. We're already down to 47 here in the city. West winds at 9 miles an hour. Temperatures across the north already down in the 30s in most areas, down to the south 40s and 50s, although Carlsbad pretty warm right now at 68. Here's our storm system right here, and we've talked about this thing and its track and how critical that is. And you can see when you have a storm sitting over the Four Corners, especially in this particular case, we've got a dry slot of air that it's drawing in across most of New Mexico. So while places like Denver are getting pasted with snow, we are on the wrong side of the track for this particular storm. And so what we're getting here is a nice moisture feed up into Colorado, skimming northeastern New Mexico with a couple of showers over the northern mountains too. But when you combine the lift and the moisture that they've got over Colorado on the north side of this storm, that's the place to be. We on the south side of this storm are drawing in that drier air, so that doesn't allow much in the way of showers. It's not that we have nothing going our way. We've got a few showers here and there, but we're going to see more of a scattered to isolated shower type of deal through tomorrow versus a big time system, which could help us with a lot of precip. If we're going to see anything, I think it'll be tomorrow evening into early Saturday with some showers possible here in the metro and some light accumulating snow over the northern mountains. But we are still very optimistic long term, and here's why. We've had high pressure set up over California throughout most of the winter. What has it led to? Well, it's led to devastating drought there. They are in severe drought conditions because of this semi-permanent high which has been sitting there. Well, New Mexico's kind of had storms edging through. We've done okay here. As you can see, our drought status not nearly as bad as it's been. But here's the piece of good news. That high, and a lot of our models are showing this, is going to work its way out, and a trough is going to set up next week. This big time West Coast trough will not only help bring more precip across California, which would be huge for them, but it's also going to track the storms farther to the south and into the southwest, a series of systems, actually, as it looks right now. So if this pans out, this would be a nice big time pattern shift, which could well help us in the long term and really could put us in a spot where we could finish up spring in a nice rotation of storms versus the dry start we've had to spring to this point. 46 Durango tomorrow, 44 Pagosa Springs, and 48 in Alamosa. Plenty of clouds, some showers out there, mostly cloudy with scattered showers in the northwest. Cool temps continue, temps in the mid-50s. Southwest, partly sunny and breezy conditions here. 62 Silver City, 69 over in TRC. Southeast, partly cloudy and breezy. Southwest winds 10 to 20 miles an hour. And we'll keep things going as far as the winds go up to the northeast. Spot showers and windy. Southwest winds 20 to 30, gusting to 40. Northern mountains, snow showers from time to time tomorrow and Saturday, because we're going to see a little series of weather disturbances kicking their way through. 54 in Edgewood, 55 in Taharis, and finally here in the metro. Partly cloudy. Some spot rain showers possible for tomorrow after a cold start. Your extended forecast, things will be relatively quiet through about Monday, you guys. Then we're looking for that change into next week.
Be a nice change. Thank you, Mark.